Hey friends, how are you all? Here is a small video I'm posting about all the questions that many people have been asking about me, about the Kundalini Shaktipat and how the event goes about. So please listen very carefully to this video. First of all, about the Kundalini advantages, that Kundalini gives perfect health and perfect mental peace and everything it gives when it is fully awakened, and all the chakras it has cleansed and opened. And one other thing is, you know, when all your once all the blocks are cleaned, chakras opening and getting balanced by any other method, you know, it will be, you know, just a temporary. But once the chakras are opened by the Kundalini, it means that, you know, it opens and cleanses all the past life karmas that are accumulated in those chakras. So I do respect there are a lot of other methods which say that they open the chakra. Yes, that chakra, that those methods are for chakra opening. But once the chakra Kundalini is opened by the chakra, once the chakras are opened by the Kundalini, they are opened by once and for all, and they get cleansed. And yes, it doesn't happen, it doesn't stay there. So once the chakras are opened and, you know, once they get balanced, then it's up to you. You are still living, you are still in a living body with a mind, and so you still have, you know, choices whether you follow a good path or a bad path. Yes, usually Kundalini awakened soul, they have this ability of walking on positive on a positive pathway, but during chakra cleansing, when all your chakras are not opened and when your karmas are cleansed from the chakras, some people are directed towards the bad path also, you know, if it's in their karmas or their karmic baggages has to make them go through those experiences. And so such people will still try to go on a negative path. And so, you know, that is also totally normal for you know, to have that kind of experience in your Kundalini awakening journey. And what else I would like to tell you is, many people, you know, they get very much attracted by this word, you know, that you will be completely healthy, like your mind, body and soul will be completely under your control. You will be able to, all your chakras will be balanced, you will be like a very superpower, you'll be possessing superpowers, you'll be possessing many siddhis. So see, well, this is not the only purpose for which you awaken your Kundalini. Well, Kundalini is a lot more than that. What I have make you counted, like, you know, the health, mind, body and spirit stays good in health, and, you know, like wellness, health and wellness, it's like, you know, almost steady, and, you know, it stays that way so that you are able to do better things in your life. The next thing, you know, having, possessing supernatural powers, possessing clairvoyant abilities, possessing what else? Yes, yeah, siddhis. Those are the main. Siddhi is the word that actually attracts a lot of people, you know, to go for Kundalini awakening. So Kundalini awakening is it is not for meant only for this purpose. These things are a byproduct of Kundalini awakened person. So you never have to run after Kundalini awakening only for this. If you run after this, well, you can imagine that what you're going to get. So Kundalini is a lot more than that. So now you'll ask me that, then what is Kundalini about? You know, if a person doesn't run after all these things, if a person doesn't wish or desire to have a lot of siddhis and supernatural powers, then what are the things that a person should why does Kundalini happen to people? Why does Kundalini awakening come to people if it is not just meant for these purposes? Well, yes, Kundalini is one big reason Kundalini awakening comes into anybody's life is for Kundalini, you know, the soul's evolution. Now, you know, many must be telling, yeah, this is something science, and that you learn this word in science and that too in school. What does it have to do over here when you're already grown, you're working, and you're already settled in your life? So what does this word have to do with you now? So, well, this word is actually evolution. It stands and it is, it happens with everyone. It happens with every species. Every plant that you see is under a process of evolution. Every animal you see is under a process of evolution. Every human being you see is under a process is under the process of evolution. If a person is going through a good time, if a person is having a lot of money to spend about and is very happy with his life, has a good thing of about everything in his life, then too that person is going under evolution process. If a person is having a hell of a life, has a lot of trouble in their life, problems in every area of life, then that person too is going under a process of evolution. And who is, more evolved and who is less evolved, you can never say. That only God can say who is more evolved and who is less evolved. And why does a human need to evolve, right? You might be thinking that humans are they are the best, they are the most intelligent species. First comes the plants, then comes the animals. They are less intelligent. They don't have their own mind to think. They cannot, express their feelings and blah blah blah, whatever stories go for them. So many people say that humans, they are more intelligent. They can express their feelings. They can, they have their own mind to decide, to think logically, to perform good, come up with great ideas, inventions, discoveries. So why does a human have to evolve then, when we are already so much evolved, when technology and everything is evolving at the speed, at jet speed? What more do we have to evolve? So well, yes. Now, this question is a bit, this question, when you ask this question, so it feels good, it feels challenging that, okay, you have challenged somebody, some spiritual person about what this is, that blah blah blah. But behind all this industrialization and the huge heights that every person is to huge leaps and heights that everybody is taking in their success, everybody is going learning a lot of things and all, it is adding somewhere or the other stress and all hectic schedules and all, somewhere or the other it is getting piled up. People are getting we don't come to know, because some person, unless you're in good in health and good in mental health, it's nothing is going to show up. But once those stress and tension and the negative feelings keep on piling up, piling up, piling up, and it one day then you have a blast, and then at that time, everybody will run after, spiritual people, spiritual gurus and everywhere that, oh, what is happening to me? What is wrong with me? So somewhere or the other, everybody needs this evolution process because, Kundalini, once it crosses all the seven chakras, it will help you, to generate, any amount of energy that you want in your body. Plus, it will, Kundalini is not, it will allow you to generate energy as much as you want in your body. It will allow you to, stay and work longer for lot many hours as per your requirement. Now, when I say as per your requirement, it doesn't mean that you keep working, it will allow you to keep working at places which you don't like. The process of evolution is the first, what teaches is first thing that, you are meant to follow your light. When you get attracted, if you are attracted doing things that you love, if you have love and passion for something else, and you are on a path, which totally drains you out, then you are not on the right path. So the first thing that you will need to do, your Kundalini will direct you towards the path, the where you follow your own light. It will never allow you to adjust to, I know, many of people, they especially the ones who are in toxic jobs, or working at toxic places, businesses, they might be feeling drained out the most, and they are the maximum people who might be watching this video of mine, to just so that they can find out a way how they're going to energize themselves, so that they can work for longer hours and fulfill the needs of their boss and get better payments and blah 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 and everything. So So, you know, Kundalini is not going to make you walk for long on a toxic path. It will first of all make you walk towards the path of your light, you know, what the talent is within you, what creative energy you possess. It will help you to grab those things, and Kundalini is going to direct you towards path, you know, that is specific for you. So you have to be open to that. Just, you know, reading the advantages and, you know, getting attracted towards courses, going for Kundalini awakening courses is not just the first and the last step in awakening Kundalini. Once you have an awakened Kundalini, you are, you know, that process is ongoing. Kundalini will keep on giving you messages and, you know, what you have to do, what you don't have to do, where you have to go, where you don't have to go. You know, constantly these messages will flow in through you, and you have to grab those messages and follow them. Or, you know, only then it can work magic for you in your life. And yes, regarding siddhis, you know, it's nobody can have siddhis like, you know, okay, wow, that's a nice siddhi, you know, this is something nice to have, this is a nice supernatural power to have. So you don't get a siddhi of your choice. Divine will give you the siddhi that suits best to your needs, best for your life purpose, best that your energies is able to, you know, the how the best your energies work out in this world. So, you know, according to that, the siddhi will be given to you. You will be saying that you know very well what you are, what you want, but siddhi is not what you ask for. You ask from the divine. Divine gives it to you according to your needs, your life purpose, and how your energy system is built. So, so that was the short message that I wanted to give about Kundalini awakening. If you all wish to have a Kundalini Shakti Path from me, there are the dates constantly updated on my blog. So you can go to it. If you need any information, you know, on any tips or techniques, like a push forward on your path, whatever experiences you are having in Kundalini, if you want an explanation for that, you will have to take a special consultation from me. And you can to get a consultation by phone or Skype, you can just mail me. I'll add the email address in the description box of this video. And yes, if you wish to have a Kundalini awakening session with me, you can just go to the blog, and you can subscribe, and you can just put the payments, and, you know, you can just notify me whenever you want to have. I usually wish to go, you know, by every month, the monthly schedule that the dates that are displayed on the blog. I like to follow those dates itself. But if you wish to have it on any other dates, like, you know, you feel, oh, you are very much ready for the awakening and you want it now and right now, so you can just mail me. And yes, the Kundalini awakening Shakti Path is given on the basis of, you know, on the basis of how your energy body is right now. If you are not, there are the rules that you will have to follow. The rules is given on my blog, kundalini-shaktipath.in. And these rules are something, you know, that will help you to cleanse your energy system. What is energy system? There is chakras and energy system, and, you know, there is this first is mental body, emotional body, and physical body. These are the main basic three bodies that have the most blockages, you know, because they connect you to this physical world. So the mental body, you know, it is just thoughts, you know, and the emotional body, there are a lot of blocks. And there is physical body, you know, where most people have blocks, you know, only 10%, 5 to not even 10%, you know, 3 to 5% people in this world, you know, they might not be having any blockages in their physical blocks or emotional blocks in their body. These blocks are, you know, formed, you know, when you have something negative, when you have some negative thought, negative emotion, negative feeling in your mind, in your body, and you're not able to get rid of it. It happens to you constantly, and it keeps you nagging, you know, anything, wherever you are, you know, it makes, oh, that is that, this person said this to me, this person said this to me, this person, you know, this person said this to me in front of so many people. So those are the, you know, those are the thoughts, you know, which make you feel bad, which make you feel negative. Those are the thoughts that, you know, once they keep running concurrently in your mind, they will create blocks. and these are the blocks that you need to cleanse, while you are in the process of Kundalini awakening. So it is not possible, for anyone to cleanse all the blocks and then come for a Kundalini awakening Shaktipath. But I would expect that, at least whoever appears for the Shaktipath are at least have at least begun the cleansing process on their own at least 1 or 2 months before the Shaktipath they want to take. So the best way to deal with those blocks is, I would like to suggest that you just go through the rules, because the rules has a lot of information how you will be able to cleanse the chakras and cleanse the blockages that is within you. What is the daily schedule, what is the daily routine that you have to follow for, what routine you'll have to make, what food you will have to eat that will help you in cleansing, what routine you have to build up that will help you to daily cleanse out. And yes, you have to follow that routine for quite a long time. Once your Kundalini awakens, your Kundalini itself will direct you towards a routine that is best for you. And then you can depend on your Kundalini, but till it's not awakened, you have to follow the rules that are given in the on my site. Even after your Kundalini awakening, you are directed towards following the rules, you feel that they are still the perfect for following, then you can go about it. And anybody who wants to take a Shaktipath, I would like to, from me especially, I don't know whether anybody else is placing this the restriction or not, but if you want to have a Shaktipath from me, I would like to suggest that if you are going through any addictions or intoxicating drugs or something, I don't allow people who are going through such, who are using such type of things, materials in their life, inside their body to appear for the Shaktipath, as these things, addictions, they happen because of emotional blockages, and when a person is going through a bad time and all that. And I know everybody has that bad time, but you're not supposed to go into these addictions, because addictions help you to make those emotional blockages, and they help you to build more and more over and over layers over layers of what that little thing is there, that is there inside you, that is troubling you. It will become grow more and more, and so addictions, they don't help anywhere in cleansing the blocks. They will temporarily make you feel good. So I will not allow anybody who is under any kind of addiction or is intaking in the intoxicating drugs or something. So if you have that habit, I would like that you just flush those things out of your body. Take at least a 6 months time to cleanse your body by detoxing and doing pranayam and all. First some might have to go through to a rehab or something. I would suggest that you go there, and once you are cleansed fully, once you get out of that addiction fully, give a 6 months time of practicing the rules. And then you can place a request for joining the Shaktipath. Once you join the Shaktipath, I will not allow you to again go to that habit, because I don't, that's not in my, those words, those things are not in my dictionary. So I don't allow people, such people, to enter into the Shaktipath and enter into my group of Kundalini Shaktipath. So decide very, very, be very, very firm in your decision. If you want to take Shaktipath from me, you will have to leave that habit forever, once and for all. And you will have to stay, we will have to stay determined on your decision, and will have to follow it for lifetime. You'll also have to follow the rules. Even after the Shaktipath is over, you will have to follow the rules. Once you have taken the Kundalini Shaktipath, it will help to activate your Kundalini. Kundalini activation helps to make you feel vibrations in your body, and vibrations. Sometimes you will awaken the Kundalini right away in some people. If they are waiting time is over, and if they have to have a quick and immediate awakening, so that it might happen that you might awaken your Kundalini on the first day itself. But for many, I feel that it does take time, and because activation, even after the activation, you have to continue with the rules, and you have to continue with all your daily schedule, and your routine work, your daily practices of your spiritual exercise, spiritual exercises to make your spiritual muscles elastic, to cleanse your system, to cleanse your blocks. So it will take time, and so I can promise you that your Kundalini will be activated. Kundalini awakening lies completely in the hands of the divine. I have to clarify this, you know, because a lot of people, you know, they come so much enthusiastically to me, you know, oh wow, Kundalini awakening is such a nice process. You're awakening, you will awaken it, right? How many days it will take to awaken? So this is the answer to them, you know, that I can activate the Kundalini, but awakening, it depends totally in the divine's hands, and a lot in your hands too, because you know, the way you do the cleansing exercises, the way you regularly do the spiritual exercises, the way you cleanse your blocks, the way you deal cleanse your blocks, etc., you know, that is also going to help you to be, you know, to get your body quickly ready for the awakening process. And what more should I say on this? I would like to know, you know, the questions that you have for Kundalini. If you have any questions that, you know, you would like me to answer regarding Kundalini, and because I would like to answer majority of the questions before you appear for the Shakti Path. And I know there are a lot of questions, you know, questions and answers regarding Kundalini, spirituality, life, they are never ending. So I won't be able to answer each and everything, but I will surely cover, you know, the main ones that, you know, that majority of people have before taking a Shakti Path or during a Shakti Path. And for the ones, you know, who wish to have, who have that itch inside them, you know, to get more and more knowledge about Kundalini, more and more knowledge about experiences from experts who have already gone through the awakening process, I would like to you to suggest that you read some nice books on that topic, you know. The good books that I have read on it, I did read after I went through an awakening process, after you know, the whole process completed, I was confused and this and that, and you know, I felt, I was like, what happened and all. And after, later on, I gathered the courage of reading the book on Kundalini. So that, you know, because first of all, I didn't know whether I was ready to read about it and was ready to accept the fact that it got awakened. So after I read a Kundalini book after quite a couple of years after, you know, awakening. And so the books that I read is Robert Swoboda's book on Kundalini. Robert Swoboda's, it is Kundalini 2, I think. And another good book is Cindy Dale's book, Kundalini and Chakras. I don't remember the name. It's an orange book, you know, with little design on the top of the cover. So you can read those books. You can even read more books. I have not read much on Kundalini, so maybe, you know, whatever is written on my side, majority is what came from my experience and, you know, from the knowledge from all the spiritual programs that I had attended. You know, majority of, you know, what experience, what the divine teaches you, you know. So that is also one thing, that, you know, learning from the books is, you know, bookish knowledge, but learning yourself while going through the experience itself, you know, I would suggest that you depend taking knowledge that way, you know. Taking Kundalini Shakti Path, you know, going following the rules and all, even if your Kundalini is not awakened, it is just activated, still, you know, it will teach you a lot. So I would like to suggest that you learn from that more, depend on those learnings more, because you know that a lot of people around the world have a lot of experiences, but those experiences are meant for them, you know. Everybody does not have the same life purpose, so you just cannot read somebody's book and think, oh, this is the thing that's going to happen to me also. But that is where, you know, most people get disheartened, you know, most of get disappointed, oh, they had such a good experience and I had this blah blah blah. So it's not that, you know, they had, some people, they have different experiences because they had to go through their life, that is their life learning, so they have to go through that kind of experience. What if that doesn't happen to you? What if your experience is a different one, it's a bit, you know, And yes, one more thing I would like to tell everyone is that, you know, that Kundalini awakening process, you know, once the Kundalini is awakened, all the seven chakras are crossed. That is where you will get all the advantages what are listed on my site. And for that to happen, it might take, you know, sometimes weeks, sometimes months, and sometimes years. To be very clear with this process, you know, because procedure, because some people, they do you think that, you know, I would be giving the Shakti path and it will awaken the Kundalini fully and all the seven chakras will cross. Well, that doesn't happen to everyone. There are very few lucky people in this world, you know, who have that experience, you know, within the first awakening that they experience. But a lot of people have a lot more blocks in their body, lot more chakras cleansing, lot more karmic baggages to be paid, you know. So for everyone, it's not going to happen easily. And also, I would say that, you know, what happens, you know, during the seven chakras crossing period, all the experiences, all the karmic, you know, pain time that was distributed, you know, all the good and bad experiences that were scattered throughout your life or throughout the average life of every human being, you know, it's usually scattered. It's like a bumpy ride, you know. It's first it's good, then it's bad, good, bad, good, bad. It keeps on going. So what Kundalini does, you know, it just compresses all those experiences, you know. All those years, suppose if you have to go through a full lifetime of bad and good experiences, it compresses all those experiences and gives you those experiences in this much time. So, you know, well, yes, this is clear. So, you can imagine that, you know, the kind of bumpy ride, if you are having this kind of bumpy ride, and once you take the Shakti path, you know, once you begin the Kundalini awakening process, once it awakens, you know, not after the Shakti path, once it awakens, the bumpy ride might become like this. So yes, it feels very good, you know, when I do this, but you feel, oh no, when it goes this. So, but that you have to accept that fact that once you are going for Kundalini awakening, so the bumpy ride is going to become this curvy and the curves are going to increase and increase, you know, till all the seven chakras are crossed. So this is what I had to say about Kundalini, you know, for maybe for now. If you want to know more, or you know, you can just drop in comments. I would like to get productive comments. If you don't have anything productive to say right now, you can comment something productive in my upcoming videos, but don't leave any negative or, you know, those kind of comments over here. I would like to get more productive comments that, you know, help this video channel to grow in a better way. I would like to get a better fan following, you know, who are really interested in Kundalini and would like to go for Kundalini awakening and who are just longing to have such an experience in their lives. So I would like to have more of people who are passionate about Kundalini. I would like to get comments from them. And for everybody else watching this video, I hope you had good knowledge. I hope you had some additional knowledge from this video. If anything in this video confuses you, or you know, you feel tricky, or what was this, that, you can just go through my website kundalini-shaktipath.in. It has a lot of information that I have given over there. If you don't find answers over there, you can write and drop in a comment to me. Well, yes, if there is something on my site and you still ask about it, I will not reply to that comment, and please bear with me with that. So okay, so see you next time with another video informative about Kundalini. You can also subscribe to my channel regarding tarot and all, because I also do tarot reading, angel reading. I give courses about tarot reading, angel reading, and Reiki. So I also give a couple of life coaching courses, you know, for self-improvement, if you are interested in improving your life, you know, on once and for all. So can also have a look, or you can also have a look at my website tarotangelreading.com, tarot-angel-reading.com. This is specially for tarot and angel readings and tarot angel related courses. nirvananow.in is my website for that, is specially set up for, you know, my life coaching and other courses that I offer, you know, other than they are like, you know, goal setting and affirmations and those kind of things, sessions that I give. And Kundalini Shaktipat is specially for giving Kundalini Shaktipat and you know everything related to the Kundalini. And there are, you can also subscribe to any all of these three sites. You know, there will be a lot of informative posts coming up, and I do like to share a lot about on my blogs too. And you know, because it's better to keep people updated for you know on such topics, because these things people want to know about more and more. And yes, I don't give any free services either related to Kundalini, either related to tarot, or no discounts for any courses or tarot readings or any other things. I would like that you respect this, and you order only if you are able to go for the, you know, the courses that are only for the charges that are written, and you can spend those, you know, spend them without making you feel icky inside. As I feel, you know, that I can give my I can give the best knowledge, you know, that if I get a certain amount, so the amount that is written on the site, you know, it will help me, because I just keep adding a lot to my knowledge base. I like to explore about things more and more, so that I can keep my fans, you know, updated about latest things, you know, to keep giving little informative videos so that people can learn from it. So you know that all that gathering knowledge and all requires money. You know, you need books, you need books, you need CDs, you need MP3 downloads and all that for getting more knowledge. You get so that costs money to me as well. So I cannot give things for free. So if you are ready to pay the amount that is listed on my site and want to buy services or courses, anything from me, you're most welcome to buy. And from what more, love to all of you. I'll be waiting for you to leave productive comments below. Just visit my blog, subscribe to them if you are interested in the topic, of course. So that's all from me now. See you next time in another video. Bye bye, love you.